Hi friends, I welcome you for the second lecture on module 3 of engineering physics on the topics Maxwell's equations, electromagnetic waves and optical fibers. Today in this session we shall discuss the prerequisites of Maxwell's equations. They are nothing but the basic vector operations. We shall discuss two vector operations. First one, the dot product, its mathematical representation and its application. Second one, the cross product, its mathematical representation and its application. What is a dot product of two vectors and why do we need these products? The dot product of two vectors is mathematically defined. Consider two vectors, vector A and vector B. This vector A and vector B are acting at an angle theta. Theta is the angle between the two vectors. A is the magnitude of vector A, B is the magnitude of vector B. The dot product of these two vectors is given by vector A dot vector B is equal to A into B into cos theta. A is a scalar, B is a scalar and cos theta is a scalar, hence the dot product of two vectors is a scalar quantity. The vectors A and B could also be represented in the Cartesian form in terms of x, y and z components. Here we have vector A. It is written as Ax into I cap plus Ay into j cap and Az into k cap. X, y and z components respectively. Similarly, the vector B is also represented in terms of the x, y and z components, that is vector B is Bx into I cap plus By into j cap plus Bz into k cap. So now the dot product of two vectors in the Cartesian form is given by vector A dot vector B is equal to Ax Bx plus Ay By plus Az Bz. Here the product Ax Bx is the product of the magnitudes of the x components of A and B, and Ay By is the product of the magnitudes of y components, and Az Bz is the product of magnitudes of the z components. So this is how we represent the dot product mathematically. So what are the properties and applications of this dot product? One good example is work done. We know that work done is given by the product of force and displacement. This is true only when force and displacement both are in the same direction. If the force is acting at an angle theta with respect to the displacement, then the dot product gives the work done, or work done is represented by the dot product of force and displacement. For example, here let us say we have displacement vector here and this is the force and it's acting at an angle theta. Now the work done is given by the component of the force in the direction of displacement. The component of this force in the direction of displacement is F cos theta and magnitude of displacement is D. So F cos theta into D is the dot product of force and displacement, and work done is a scalar quantity. Now the work done is maximum if force and displacement are in the same direction. If the applied force and the displacement are in the same direction, then the work done is maximum, and work done is zero if the force and displacement are in mutually perpendicular directions. It means the force that is acting in this direction cannot produce a displacement horizontally. That is the meaning of that. Then in case of a friction force, the friction force acts in a direction opposite to that of the motion, and hence the work done by the friction force is negative, because the angle between force and displacement is 180 degree, cos pi is minus 1, hence the work done is negative. This dot product could also be used to calculate the projection of one vector on the other, and this dot product could also be used to calculate the flux of a field through a given surface. Now let us understand these two. See, we have vector A here and vector B. The projection of vector A on vector B is given by the dot product of A and B divided by the magnitude of vector B. It is because of the reason the component of A in the direction of B is given by A cos theta. Okay. A into B into cos theta is the dot product. So, therefore, we want A cos theta here. So, A cos theta is dot product of A and B divided by the magnitude of B. The second application is the flux of a field through a given surface. Now, let us say we have a surface, we attach a vector to this surface, the magnitude of this vector is equal to the area of this surface and it is normal to the surface, and similarly we have here, this is the area vector and this is the surface. Now, the flux through this surface depends on the orientation of this surface or the angle made by this area vector with respect to the electric field within which it is placed. Therefore, the flux through this particular surface is given by the dot product of electric field and the area vector. So, it is like, if the surface is perpendicular to the field, then the area vector and the field are in the same direction and maximum number of flux lines pass through this surface. As the orientation changes, okay, the number of flux lines passing through this surface decreases, and when the surface becomes horizontal, then the area vector will be perpendicular to the field, the flux through the surface is zero. Therefore, flux of an electric field through a given surface could be represented as the dot product of the field and the area vector, electric field and the area vector. To have a better understanding in these topics, let us watch this video.
This video is sponsored by Brilliant. If you click this video, you probably already know that the dot product of two vectors can be found by multiplying the magnitudes of those vectors together and then multiplying by cosine of the angle between them. If you have the vectors written in component form, then you multiply the x components and the y components and then add the results, at least for two dimensions, and you get that same value. One way to think about this numerical value you get after doing the dot product is it's a measure of how similar the two vectors are. Well, this is more accurate to say when each vector has a length of 1. If we say these are both unit vectors right now, then the dot product would be 1, since the angle between them is 0. When the angle is 90, then the dot product is 0. And when the vectors point in opposite directions, the dot product is negative 1. So, for unit vectors, the dot product can be thought of as a measure of how similar the vectors are on a scale of negative 1 to 1. So now, where in the real world would we care about any of this? Well, one simple example would be what you're seeing here, with solar panels. If you draw a unit normal vector that is coming directly off a solar panel, and another pointing directly at the sun, how similar those vectors are, or their dot product, would be a factor in how much solar energy is absorbed, since the more the solar panels are directly pointing at the sun, the more energy you get. Or another simple application, which is probably the first for a lot of us, is with work done by some force. If you pull a block or wagon or something at an angle along a frictionless surface, so long as you don't pull too hard, that object will slide along the floor in the direction of D. And the closer that force vector is to the direction of motion, the larger a change in kinetic energy you get over some distance. And this can be seen in the equation for change in kinetic energy being force dot distance.
Having discussed about the dot product, now we shall discuss and understand the cross product of two vectors, the cross product of two vectors is mathematically defined as vector A cross vector B is equal to A into B into sin theta into n cap. Here A is the magnitude of vector A, B is the magnitude of vector B, and theta is the angle between the two vectors, and n cap is a unit vector perpendicular to both A and B or perpendicular to the plane containing A and B. If A and B are the vectors in this plane, then n cap will be in a direction perpendicular to both A and B. It means the cross product of two vectors will be normal to the plane containing the two vectors. We can represent the two vectors A and B in the Cartesian form, then the cross product of vector A and vector B is given by the determinant of I cap, J cap, K cap, AX, AY, AZ, BX, BY, BZ. If we expand this determinant, you get a vector, and that vector is a result of the cross product of two vectors and is in a direction normal to the plane containing A and B. The cross product of two vectors is a vector quantity, hence it is also called as a vector product, and as you know, the cross product is normal to the plane containing the two vectors. Now, what is the application of this cross product? Now, let us imagine a situation wherein a charge is entering a magnetic field, and this is the direction of magnetic field towards my right. So, now this is the velocity vector and this is the magnetic field. Now, this charge moving in a magnetic field experiences a force, and hence it takes a circular path, and this force experienced by a charge moving in a magnetic field is given by Fm, vector Fm is equal to q into vector v cross vector b. V is the velocity vector and b is the magnetic field vector. Another example for this cross product is the torque. Torque is a rotational or twisting effect caused by the force. In translatory motion, we consider force, whereas in rotational or twisting motion, we consider torque. This torque is the moment of force. This tau is given by R cross F. The cross product is not commutative in nature, as the direction of the n cap changes. If it is A cross B, n cap will be in one direction. If it is B cross A, the unit vector will be in an opposite direction, then it becomes minus n cap, and hence A cross B and B cross A, they are not in the same direction, hence the cross product is not commutative. We can understand this motion of a charge in a magnetic field by watching this video, so that you get a clear picture of application of the cross product.
Consider a freely moving positive charge Q entering the magnetic field such that vector V is perpendicular to vector B. For this case, theta equals 90 degrees, and hence the magnitude of the magnetic force is maximum and is FB equals QVB. To find the direction of FB on the positive charge, we use the right-hand rule. Orient your first finger along the velocity vector V and second finger along the magnetic field vector B. The direction of the thumb gives the direction of the magnetic force FB. This force changes the path of the charge in the magnetic field. At point L, the force FB is perpendicular to V. This force bends the trajectory of the charge and it reaches M. At this point, the force pulls the charge inward, bending its path further, and the charge reaches the point N. The charge is acted upon by a constant centripetal magnetic force at every point of its trajectory.
With this, we complete our discussion on the dot product and the cross product of two vectors. Just for the sake of assessment, we have two MCQs here. The first MCQ, the dot product of vectors could be applied to calculate option 1, work done, option 2, flux of a vector field, option 3, similarity of two vectors, and fourth option, all. So, please mark your answer. Okay, friends, as per the discussion held, the work done is the dot product of force and displacement. Flux of a vector field could be calculated by taking the dot product of area vector and the electric field. Then similarity of the two vectors could be understood by taking the dot product of two vectors, and hence the option is all. So, dot product of vectors could be applied in all the three cases 1, 2 and 3, and hence the correct option is all, that is 4. MCQ 2, it states that which of the following is not an example for the cross product: torque, option 1, 2, angular momentum, 3, area vector of a parallelogram, and 4, none. Please mark your answer. Okay, friends, we have already discussed that this torque is the twisting effect produced by the force, tau is equal to r cross f, and hence it is a cross product, it represents a cross product. Angular momentum L is the moment of linear momentum, L is equal to r cross p, and hence angular momentum is also represented by the cross product. Then the third one, area of the parallelogram, if we represent the edges, two adjacent edges of a parallelogram by two vectors, then the cross product of these two vectors gives the area of the parallelogram, and that area vector will be in a direction normal to the plane containing the two vectors, and hence torque, angular momentum and area vector of a parallelogram are represented by the cross product, and hence the correct option is none, because in the question we have which of the following is not an example, all the three are examples, and hence the correct option is none. With this, we have come to the end of the session. Let us recall what we have discussed. We discussed about the dot product and cross product, their mathematical representation and their applications. Dot product is applied when we calculate the work done, and cross product is applied in a situation wherein we calculate the force experienced by a moving charge in a magnetic field. So, with this, we have come to the end of this session, and I would like to wrap up the session with a quote by Albert Einstein. The quote is, "Everyone is a genius, remember." Thank you very much. Thank you for patience listening. Bye. See you.